Real Madrid are one match away from lifting the Champions League trophy for a third consecutive year and a fourth time in 5 years. Sven Ulreich's second-half slip gifted Real Madrid a vital goal on their way to qualifying for another Champions League final. Real Madrid are one match away from lifting the Champions League trophy for a third consecutive year and a fourth time in 5 years. Madrid, three snap thoughts from the Bernabeu as Real Madrid make it back to the Champions League final for the fourth time in 5 years with a 2-2 draw in Tuesday's Champions League semi-final, second leg, at home to Bayern Munich for a 4-3 aggregate win. Real Madrid do enough yet again. Karim Benzema was the surprise hero on another extremely dramatic night at the Bernabeu as Real Madrid just did enough to edge out Bayern Munich and keep their bid for a third consecutive Champions League alive. A pulsating game flowed back and forth as Bayern right back Joshua Kimmich again opened the scoring before the recalled Benzema scored twice to put Madrid in control of the tie, only for James Rodriguez to net against his former side to put things on edge again. For a second consecutive year, Bayern left the Bernabeu and the competition, cursing their luck and refereeing decisions. Over the two legs, Madrid were just the better, and especially the more streetwise side. "We defend the throne, we win the glory," said the banner behind the Bernabeu's south goal before kickoff, but it was the visitors who began looking much the more composed, with Franck Ribéry testing stand-in right back Lucas Vázquez. The home crowd was feeling much less confident just 3 minutes in, when dodgy defending at the back allowed Bayern fullback Kimmich in to score just as head last week in Germany. Madrid did not take long to reply. Marcelo produced a pearl of a cross from the left and recalled center forward Benzema lost marker David Alaba and confidently headed home. Neither team eased up on the tempo. Bayern continued to find it very easy to get at Madrid's defense, with first Ribéry and then Mats Hummels allowed to carry the ball for way too long, but Keylor Navas saved weak shots to deny Thomas Müller and Robert Lewandowski. The second rebound fell for ex-Madrid playmaker James, but on the stretch, the Colombia international fired over the bar from 3 yards out. Madrid had their chances too. Cristiano Ronaldo was denied at his near post by Bayern goalkeeper Sven Ulreich and Sergio Ramos headed the subsequent corner into the side netting. Halftime brought a welcome breather for both sides, though Bayern were left complaining they deserved a penalty for a Marcelo handball just before the whistle. The second half could not have begun in worse fashion for Bayern. Ulreich slipped while trying to decide how to deal with a back pass, even though no real player was close enough to apply pressure. The ball ran clear of the Bayern goalkeeper and Benzema accepted the gift to fire into an empty net with just 18 seconds played. Visitors had to attack even more from that point, with David Alaba superbly denied by Navas and Lewandowski not given a very plausible penalty claim against Sergio Ramos. At the other end, Ronaldo had two close-range chances inside 30 seconds but could take neither. Those misses soon seemed more important when his former teammate, James, fired home the rebound from a tight angle through Navas after his own first shot was blocked. Revitalized, the visitors surged again and Lewandowski coaxed two brilliant saves from Navas in quick succession. Substitute Gareth Bale could have sealed it but failed to convert, which left 5 minutes of added time agony, but Zidane's side held on, with Ramos and Rafael Varane outstanding, to make it to another final in Kiev in 3 weeks' time. Real Madrid rode their luck but did just enough to book a spot in the Champions League final. 2. Redemption for Benzema. Benzema's return to the Madrid 11 was greeted with skepticism by many among the Bernabeu pundits and some fans whistled and booed when his name was read out before the game. The exiled France international had not scored an open play since mid-February and had looked generally woefully out of sorts in recent weeks. Benzema hadn't started either of Madrid's two most recent games in the competition and was realistically only active on Tuesday night due to an injury to Isco. But he took advantage to give his best display of the season. The early goal clearly gave him confidence, he looked like the roving, powerful nine of big games passed, linking the play cleverly, drawing defenders out of position and opening up space for strike partner Ronaldo. Benzema is a lot more than a foil for his star teammate, however. The gift from Ulreich early in the second half was his 55th goal in the European Cup, making him the sixth highest scorer in the competition's history. He's not been Madrid's key goal scorer at any time, but over his career, he's been a scorer of key goals. Would do so again on Tuesday night when Real needed him most. Bayern scored twice to give themselves a lifeline, but individual errors doomed their comeback. 3. tired, defeated Bayern need a rebuild after the first leg in Munich. Bayern players past and present had lamented their inability to finish their chances, and that narrative is sure to continue now as Lewandowski and Müller continued where they left off in the first leg, missing chance after chance. Madrid's novice was regularly in action between the posts but, aside from fine saves to deny David Alaba and Corentin Tolisso, was not tested consistently enough. Ribery was the visitor's most dangerous threat in both legs but did most of his best work in creating chance for teammates that were then missed. Their second goal on Tuesday came from this season's new addition, playmaker James, and was mostly all his own work. Lewandowski is still remembered for his 4 goals against Madrid for Borussia Dortmund, but that was 5 long years ago. Müller has still never scored against Los Blancos, and a feature of both their Bayern careers is now losing Champions League semi-finals to La Liga opponents, while Barcelona and Atletico Madrid have also eliminated the Bavarians. It is true that individual errors in both legs by Rafinha and Ulrich really killed Bayern's chances. But a summer shakeup seems inevitable, with incoming coach Niko Kovac to be provided with some newer, younger attacking options. This Bayern attack appears to have come to the end of the road. Dermot Corrigan is a Madrid-based football writer who covers La Liga and the Spain national team for ESPN FC. Follow him on Twitter at @DermotMCorrigan. Page 2. Real Madrid are one match away from lifting the Champions League trophy for a third consecutive year and a fourth time in 5 years. Real Madrid are one match away from lifting the Champions League trophy for a third consecutive year and a fourth time in 5 years. Real Madrid are through to their third straight Champions League final, but the FC crew explain how Bayern Munich gave away the trip to Kiev. Relive the best from another big night at the Santiago Bernabeu, as Real Madrid prevailed over Bayern to reach the Champions League final again. Sven Ulrich's second-half slip gifted Real Madrid a vital goal on their way to qualifying for another Champions League final. Madrid, if you hear anyone trying to tell you that this wasn't absolute sublime quality, five-star, technically exquisite football, then shun them. If you read or listen to someone droning on about how this Champions League semi-final between Bayern Munich and Real Madrid was decided only by mistakes, that there were too many errors to make this a classic, too many errors to suggest that Madrid can possibly be a threat to either Roma or Liverpool in the final, then either blow them a giant raspberry. Real Madrid are one match away from lifting the Champions League trophy for a third consecutive year and a fourth time in 5 years. Sven Ulrich's second-half slip gifted Real Madrid a vital goal on their way to qualifying for another Champions League final. Real Madrid are one match away from lifting the Champions League trophy for a third consecutive year and a fourth time in 5 years. Madrid, 3 snap thoughts from the Bernabeu as Real Madrid make it back to the Champions League final for the fourth time in 5 years with a 2-2 draw in Tuesday's Champions League semi-final, second leg, at home to Bayern Munich for a 4-3 aggregate win. Real Madrid do enough yet again. Karim Benzema was the surprise hero on another extremely dramatic night at the Bernabeu as Real Madrid just did enough to edge out Bayern Munich and keep their bid for a third consecutive Champions League. Dele Alli started the scoring and Harry Kane netted his 27th goal of the season as Tottenham handled Watford. Dele Alli started the scoring and Harry Kane netted his 27th goal of the season as Tottenham handled Watford. Harry Kane reacts to Spurs' win over Watford, his desire to hit the 30-goal mark in the race for the Golden Boot and more. Mauricio Pochettino says Tottenham were far from their best against Watford. London, 3 quick thoughts from Tottenham's 2-0 win over Watford at Wembley Stadium, sealed by goals from Harry Kane and Dele Alli. 1. Spurs strengthened grip on fourth-place Champions League chasing Tottenham moved 5 points clear of Chelsea with an entertaining but unconvincing win against Watford at Wembley. England internationals Kane and Alli responded to recent criticism, which has surprised their manager Mauricio Pochettino, with goals either side of halftime, as Spurs strengthened. Arsene Wenger's final trip to Old Trafford ended on a sour note for Arsenal, as Marouane Fellaini scored a stoppage-time winner for Man United. The ESPN FC guys react to the pleasantries exchanged between Arsene Wenger and Jose Mourinho before the encounter between Arsenal and Man United. Despite Arsenal's defeat at Old Trafford, a light-hearted Arsene Wenger expresses his gratitude to Man United for honoring him before the match. Paul Pogba quips about Marouane Fellaini's ability to score every which way for Man United, after the Belgian's last gasp header broke Arsenal hearts. Arsene Wenger's final trip to Old Trafford ended on a sour note for Arsenal, as Marouane Fellaini scored a stoppage-time winner for Man United. Manchester, England, there was a touch of class to the way Manchester United saw Arsene Wenger off. The Old Trafford supporters giving the Arsenal manager not one standing ovation, but two, while Sir Alex Ferguson handed his old foe a silver vase in a pre-match presentation. Quite rightly, Wenger was treated like the legendary figure that he is, and it probably meant more that the fond farewell was afforded by United and Ferguson considering the battles between the two clubs and managers over. Arsene Wenger's final trip to Old Trafford ended on a sour note for Arsenal, as Marouane Fellaini scored a stoppage time winner for Man United. Arsene Wenger's final trip to Old Trafford ended on a sour note for Arsenal, as Marouane Fellaini scored a stoppage time winner for Man United. Paul Pogba quips about Marouane Fellaini's ability to score every which way for Man United, after the Belgian's last gasp header broke Arsenal hearts. Man United boss Jose Mourinho confirms Arsenal match winner Marouane Fellaini is close to penning a new deal with the club. Despite Arsenal's defeat at Old Trafford, a light-hearted Arsene Wenger expresses his gratitude to Man United for honouring him before the match. As Manchester United look set to finish second place in this year's Premier League, manager Jose Mourinho believes the club have progressed but they need to aim higher. The ESPN FC guys react to the pleasantries exchanged between Arsene Wenger and Jose Mourinho before the encounter between Arsenal and Man United. Manchester, England, three thoughts from Man United's dramatic 2-1 win over Arsenal at Old Trafford. Wenger witnesses defeat in final Old Trafford trip. Arsene Wenger received a standing ovation from Manchester United supporters and a pre-match gift from Sir Alex Ferguson, but the Arsenal manager's final trip to Old Trafford ended in a 2-1 defeat and kept his team waiting for their first away point of 2018. Wenger, who confirmed last week that he will end his 22-year reign as Arsenal manager. Man City eclipsed a century of Premier League goals for the season and matched Chelsea's record of 30 wins in a season with a 4-1 victory at West Ham. Man City eclipsed a century of Premier League goals for the season and matched Chelsea's record of 30 wins in a season with a 4-1 victory at West Ham. Raheem Sterling feels Man City slowed down after their fourth goal at West Ham, but lauds how they closed out the match at London Stadium. Premier League champions Manchester City will continue to play at full strength for the rest of the campaign, says boss Pep Guardiola after beating West Ham 4-1. London, three thoughts from London Stadium as Man City wrapped up a comprehensive 4-1 victory over West Ham. Man City win big to match Chelsea's record. Manchester City were simply too good on Sunday for West Ham as they hit another milestone in their stunning Premier League campaign and matched another with a 4-1 win. Not only did they become the fourth team to break the 100-goal mark for the season, the record is 103, but they pulled level with Chelsea on 30 league victories. With three, page three, Greg Burley wonders if clinching the Bundesliga title so early led to Bayern's uneven performance in the first leg against Real Madrid. Substitute Marco Asensio's second half strike proved decisive as Real Madrid held on at the Allianz Arena for a big win. Assuming Real Madrid get past Bayern Munich, the ESPN FC pundits don't favor them against Liverpool, their likely opponent. Munich. In an interview earlier this week, Liverpool manager Jurgen Klopp admitted that he has never brought himself to watch again the 2013 Champions League final. An all-German affair, played before a rapturous Wembley crowd, ended with Arjen Robben's winner dampening the exuberance of Klopp's Borussia Dortmund, who could hardly have done more in attempting to upset the odds. Bayern, though, that distillation of cockiness and know-how, found a way to win yet again that night, and outgoing manager Jupp Heynckes was able to hand the incoming Pep Guardiola a treble-winning team that sat proudly on top of the world. If that game still makes agonizing viewing for Klopp, then perhaps what has gone since is an awkward watch for Bayern. While they remain dominant in the Bundesliga, similar moments in Europe have been elusive in the half-decade since that glory night in London. Whereas Dortmund sparkled but fell short at Wembley, it is now Bayern, still laden with quality, who find the fine margins going against them. Next Tuesday, they will walk out at the Bernabeu in hope rather than expectation and kick off their Champions League semi-final second leg trailing Real Madrid 2-1. But it should never have been that way. Decisive errors at either end of the pitch aside, Bayern were better than Madrid during the tie's first meeting at the Allianz Arena. The problem, though, is that is becoming a familiar lament when they reach the competition's latter stages and, this season at least, it will take something special to break the cycle. We weren't clinical enough, admitted Heynckes, now back in the Bayern dugout, on Tuesday. I haven't seen something like that from us, it doesn't happen very often, but while that may be true domestically, where Bayern rattle out almost 3 goals a game on average and nobody minds too much when opportunities to add garnish go begging, it is a repeat occurrence in Europe and especially against Real. Bayern should have put the eventual winners to the sword in last season's quarterfinals but, instead, contrived exactly the inconvenience they face now and lost the first leg at home, 2-1, having opened the scoring. 3 years earlier, Madrid overwhelmed Guardiola's side 5-0 in the semi-finals. Bayern Munich are facing their fourth semi-final defeat in 5 seasons since winning the Champions League in 2013. Only 5 of the players who were involved in a chastening second leg, which saw Bayern concede 4 times at home, were in action on Wednesday, but it is pertinent to wonder whether something snapped that night in 2014. Bayern are not quite the force of old and there is a sense that past disappointments are weighing them down. It is the opposite for Real Madrid, whose winning instinct is so fine-tuned that they can turn in what was, despite Zinedine Zidane's post-game insistence that, overall, we controlled the game very well, an average performance and still emerge, not only as winners but as resounding tournament favorites. Their sense of certainty was the one with which Bayern walked out at Wembley 5 years ago. Perhaps Zidane was watching a match in which Robert Lewandowski did not fluff free headers and shoot wide when put through on goal, or one in which Frank Ribery never had the chance to lose his footing with the goal gaping, or one that did not allow Thomas Muller an air shot from a matter of feet away. But maybe that sense of assuredness simply comes from being Real Madrid. There are few modern-day demons to haunt them, no unwanted ghosts to surface during moments of tension and minimal neuroses to tilt the balance. Real play a European tie and Real eventually win, why, in an era of dominance that has seen them win 3 of the last 4 European Cups, should it be any other way? The match showed Real can be harmed in defense and, if you look at their home match against Juventus, it was the same, Heineke said. We can take hope out of it. It is that speculative word again, hope, they had plenty of it last year when they went 2-1 up in the second leg and forced extra time, only for Arturo Vidal's red card to spark a Cristiano Ronaldo-led onslaught by Madrid. Bayern is a club where second best cuts no ice but has become force of habit. At this rarefied level, they have become a team for whom the hard luck stories can be reeled off. Consider the semi-final against Atletico Madrid 2 years ago, when Muller's missed penalty at 1-0 allowed Diego Simeone's side away back into the game and, ultimately, to the final. Beyond Heinke's laments about his team's profligacy there was the observation that Bayern created chances, in a very nice way, I have to say, nobody would dispute that. Ribery showed throughout that he is no faded force at 35 and Thiago Alcantara was a formidable creative force in the first half after replacing the injured Robin. James Rodriguez, meanwhile, was full of purpose and intent and showed some fine touches. One set up a goal for Joshua Kimmich, who was so effective going forward, though questionable when asked to defend. The German champions were fluid, easy on the eye, Real, by contrast, bordered on the stodgy. But therein lies the catch, nice teams rarely win Champions Leagues. Perhaps a Bayern group viewing of that magical London afternoon of 5 years ago might serve to underline the point. Nick Ames is a football journalist who writes for ESPN FC on a range of topics. Twitter, @NickAmes82.